the middle. Are you ready? Yeah! Everybody over here, are you ready? Yeah! All right, Atlanta, let's have a good time. Let's set it off. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, our star of the evening. You know him from Beverly Hills Cop, from New Jack City, from Saturday Night Live, from Boomerang, CB4, and Living Color. Come on, put your hands together. Make some noise. Come on, I can't hear you, Atlanta. Give it up for Mr. Chris.
Doing a new movie, got a new TV show, successful black man. So you know what's next, right? White girl. Cannot be a successful black man without a white girl. They won't even let you buy a mansion without a white girl. But here's $1 million. Where's your white girl? We have zoning restrictions. You know what's funny? If you're black and you go out with a white girl, everything that goes wrong in your life, people blame it on the white girl. Everything. It's like, yo, man, I heard Chris got hit by a bus. Fuck around with the white girl. I heard Chris broke his leg. White girl. That's what he get. People are bugs, man. It's like, you know, there's white girls that only got with black guys. There's black girls that only got with white guys. I met a black girl like that. Did not date black men. I said, girl, how come you don't date no black men? She said, no reason. No reason. I'm like, no reason. So I punched her in the face. Now she got a reason. Probably got a white girl right there, huh? You must have really wanted a white girl. Like you would pray to God every night for a white girl. Like, God bless mommy and daddy. And please bring me a white girl. I see like a fine sister with a white guy. I get pissed. I get mad. Mad. You know, I don't get violent, but I get mad. I see a fine sister with a white guy. I'm like, damn, baby, what do I got to do to get with you? I mean, what must I do? You see a girl with a rich guy, it's like, fuck it, I'll get a car someday. I just gotta work another shift, that's all.
shit with a white guy. I was like, damn, baby, what do I got to do to get with you? And I see a white guy with an ugly sister. I'm like, hey, thanks a lot, man. Thanks for taking our ugly ass off our hands. Because we didn't know what he was going to do about her. I remember, what's the girl? The ice skating girl. Debbie Thomas. Remember? Ice skating girl. She married a white guy. Married. Walked down the aisle. I was mad at first. I was like, damn, Debbie, what do I got to do to get with you? But then I thought it over. I said, you know what? I bet she didn't meet a lot of brothers on the ice. There was no brothers skating by like, hey, what's up, girl? Yeah, I got tickets to the Snoop Dogg show. Debbie Thomas went to the Olympics, bust her ass. Fuck around with the white boy. That's what she gets. She was even in the Olympics. That's like some amazing shit to me. Like black people in the Olympics representing America. That's like weird. Realize no matter how fucked up this country's been racially, there's always been black people in the Olympics. No matter how far back you go, they had black people in the Olympics in the 20s. In the 20s. Now a brother was at the back of the bus in the 60s. In the 20s, a brother must have been inside the engine of the bus. On a conveyor belt chasing a piece of chicken. Brothers in the Olympics went and won shit. Sent my ass to the Olympics back in the 20s. Shit, America wouldn't have won a damn thing. I'd take a javelin and throw it through the fucking judge's heart. Wouldn't have won nothing, man. The brothers went to the Olympics and represented. That's the problem with black people. We want to be down. Everybody else forms their own shit. They get dissed, they form their own shit. Chinese people came over here, they got dissed. It's like, yo, man, fuck you, Chinatown, right? Got their own shit. Italian people came over here, they got dissed. It's like, yo, man, fuck you, Little Italy, right? They got their own shit. Yo, I don't give a fuck what city you go into. You will not find Little Africa anywhere. There is no Little Africa. What, the ghetto little burnt up Africa? Black people, we got it bad, man. We don't even have food. There's no black food. Soul food is not black food, right? That's some nasty shit they fed to the slaves, right? You think a ham hock tasted good the first time the white man gave it to us? We put some seasoning on it and made it work, okay? Black people, we don't even have salad dressing. We don't have salad. Everybody got salad dressing. No black salad dressing. You know what black salad dressing is? Hot sauce. I know brothers that carry hot sauce with them. Got my hot sauce. Everybody want to make some money. And I don't blame you. I want to make some money. That's why I'm here, trying to make some money. Trying to make some money and keep it to myself. Because people will take your money. You ever have somebody owe you money and have the nerve to wear new clothes around you? Brand new clothes, and they point them out like, hey, look what I just picked up. Well, did you see my money while you were down there? Yo, you gotta get your money back quick from people, because people get used to owing you money. It becomes a character trait. Like, you got a fat friend, you got a bald friend, you got a friend that owes you about $50. Everybody got that friend. You ever had people owe you money so long, they start telling you about shit they're getting ready to buy? Hey, next week we're gonna buy a house. I guess you're gonna be $50 short then, huh? People owe owe you money, then what happens? You have to confront them. You have to hunt them down. You got to turn into Beretta to get your money back. And you got to walk over to your Phil, man. Your Phil, man. Don't you owe me $50? Didn't I give you $50? Now, if I didn't, let me know I'm bothering you no more. But didn't I give you $50? Wasn't that you? Wasn't that me? Wasn't that my hand? Wasn't that your hand? Didn't I give you $50? Wasn't that? Now, let me know. You do all that, then they go, man, I forgot. Now, you know that's a lie. You know that's a lie. How the fuck you gonna forget where you got some free money from? You don't forget that. If you found $50 on the ground, you would remember that shit for the rest of your life. Every time you walk by that spot, you be like, this is where I found $50. Right here, April 14th, 1972. I remember, it was a cloudy day, about 6 to 8 degrees. I had my light blue hat on. I love that hat. It was about 42% humidity outside, and your mama was pregnant with Warren. And I told her, don't drink while you're pregnant. Now Warren got 3 toes. Anyway, I look at the ground, I see 10 dimes, 4 quarters, and a $48 bill. Men never lend money to women. And women never lend money to men. You cannot lend money to people you're fucking. Because they think the sex is the payback. Especially men, the women. I dare any man in here to try and get back some money from a woman he's fucking. Just attempt it. Just step to her like, hey, man, what's up with that $200 you all with? She'll look at you like, excuse me? I think I paid you last night. Matter of fact, you owe me $150. So, I do a lot of racial humor. You know why? I was bused to school when I was a kid. Very hard being bused, man. Had to get up every morning at 6 o'clock in the morning to go to school and compete with white kids that didn't have to wake up until 8. And that's not fair. You know, say I get a lower mark on a test, I got a teacher going, oh, Chris can't read. I'm like, no, Chris is fucking tired, right? Another crazy thing is, people talk about being bused to school. I got bused to school. Like, you're supposed to get bused to school to go to a better neighborhood and get a better education and all that shit. I got bused to school into a poor white neighborhood. A neighborhood worse than the one I lived in. Everybody's scared of black people. Everybody's scared of Puerto Ricans. Yo, ain't nothing scarier than poor white people. Even white people are scared of poor white people. Hey, keep those white people away from us. Yo, these motherfuckers, they live under the trailer home, all right? They weren't white trash, they're like white toxic waste. A bunch of Shaggy from Scooby-Doo looking people. That's who I went to school with. And they hated my guts. They hated me. Because my family had more money than them. We didn't even have money, but we had more money than them. And right then I learned my lesson, boy. Nothing that a white guy with a penny hates more than a nigga with a nickel. Women here. That's good. I like women. My mother's a woman. That helps. Women got. Women